Hello, and welcome back to another year at SCSU TV News, your number one source for campus news and information. I'm Aaliyah Carangelo.
And I'm Julie Marortiz. This has been an exciting semester so far, with the inauguration of the school's new president, Dr. Mary Papazian, as well as the opening of the new School of Business and the early season of success for our athletic teams.
Last Friday, September 28th, was the inauguration ceremony of Southern's 11th president, Dr. Mary Papazian. Despite the bad weather, seats in the Lyman Center were filled with students, alumni, and friends and family of Dr. Papazian. Many high elected officials, such as Nancy Wyman, the Lieutenant Governor, Mayor of New Haven John DeStefano, and Congresswoman Rosa DeLauro, all spoke at the ceremony to welcome our new president. Even the students and faculty showed their support by being in a welcome video coordinated by Eric LaCharity, Assistant Director of Student Life. The entire ceremony can be viewed on the Southern CT YouTube channel.
September 21st was the official opening and ribbon-cutting ceremony of the new School of Business. Many business student alumni came back to campus to get their first look at the new and improved School of Business. The building has many new features, including a stock exchange room, where students can constantly keep track of the stock market, as well as many new conference rooms. The new building is replacing the much outdated Seabury Hall, which will begin being demolished later this month.
Southern now has a first-class home for its business programs, which are among the most in demand for our students.
In light of the 2012 election coming up, Southern was visited by Connecticut Senate candidate Chris Murphy last week. In a packed room full of students, supporters, and even protesters, Murphy spoke with the public about his views and plan for action in Washington. He answered questions from the audience and compared his campaign strategy with the strategy of opponent Linda McMahon. This year's election will be held Tuesday, November 6th.
Students and faculty members gathered outside of the Adante Student Center patio for Fiesta Latina 2012 on Monday, September 17th. Southern's Multicultural Center and the Organization of Latin American Students hosted the event with a seven-piece band called Sun 7. They performed the sound of Coldplay with their own Latin rock and salsa rendition of the album Clocks. Students were invited to enjoy live music, cultural food, and fun beverages. We met up with OLAS Publicity Chair Felix Ridges to discuss the event.
This month is Hispanic Heritage Month, so we kind of wanted to introduce what Hispanic Heritage is to the campus. I feel like a lot of people are kind of unaware of it, so we're just kind of trying to bring it to the forefront.
The men's soccer team has started off the season with a great start. The home opener against St. Rose was a very important game for transfer student Mario DiMaselli, who recorded a hat trick on his debut. Originally from Belgium, DiMaselli started off the game on the right foot, scoring Southern's first goal. The Owls won the game 4-0, with the other goal coming from captain Mario Costa. The Owls pulled in another win as they beat local rivals UNH 2-0. The Owls are now 4-1-1 and are ranked number 24 in the nation. Be sure to check them out at their next home game at 7 p.m. October 9th at Jess Dow Field.
Despite a rough start to the beginning of the season, the Owls football team bounced back this past weekend in a comeback against St. Anselm College. The fourth quarter comeback was largely in part of a performance from running back Vaughn McGee. He set an NCAA record of 187 yards rushing in the fourth quarter and scored the team's final three touchdowns. Currently 1-4, the Owls' next game is away against Pace University this Saturday at 1 p.m.
I know we were down coming into the half, but everyone just kept their heads up and kept playing, you know, didn't give up on one another, didn't point any fingers, just came out and just kept trying to, you know, stay positive and do good. And it just started to work out towards the end.
Well, I'm very proud of our players. We had our backs to the wall. We maintained our poise. Guys had an excellent fourth quarter. I think we were down by 10 at that point. But, you know, we preached to our guys it's important to play the whole game, to finish the game, and they came out and finished the game today.
Thank you for joining us for this week's show.
Make sure to like our Facebook page and follow us on Twitter to stay connected for updates on campus news and events.